The gingham costume that Margot wears at the beginning of the movie, it's an interesting place to start because in some ways it encapsulates so many of the themes that we're investigating in the movie. The first thing that I'd say about it is that it's a good example of how we related to the idea of Barbie's wardrobe coming in packs of clothing. So that there's within the pack, you have all of the accessories and all of the things that match. And you also have the clothes that she may use for a different activity in the same day, so that things are related, but not necessarily the same. So for the gingham costume, we have the dress that she leaves the house in, but we also have the swimsuit and the hat. We have the bags, we have the shoes, we have two different sets of shoes. So we have this whole combination of costume that adds up to the idea of a pack. There is also a Barbie costume that's blue and white, striped cotton, a cotton sundress, which is very similar. So you have our Barbie Margot in a pink gingham dress, which is based on a Brigitte Bardot dress, but which happens to be also very similar to a Mattel striped summer dress, all from the same period. Because everything, fashion, Barbie, everything is interlinked. Obviously, pink is going to play a big part in this movie, and we tested pinks extensively with Rodrigo at the beginning of the process. We tested it on fabrics, on the walls, in all different ways, just to see how the lighting was going to affect the different tones. Ultimately, we landed on a selection of pinks that would make up the environment, Barbie's environment, and we worked really closely together, Sarah Greenwood, Katie Spencer, and myself, to line up our pinks to make sure that we were always going to coordinate in any set. About quite close to the beginning of the film, possibly scene 20, Barbie has a block party. It was a challenge to think how to dress Barbie and all her friends for the best party ever. So I spoke to Kim Colmoni, the designer at Mattel, and I asked her if it was possible to get reference of all the party clothes that had ever been designed for Barbie in white and gold over the decades. And she very kindly sent me this document, and I went through it, and I chose different looks from that, and I had them made. And basically, the block party, if you really know Barbie, is a representation of the history of Barbie in one scene. One of the things that inspired me the most to take this direction is I found a picture of Ken in about 1976 wearing a one piece. It actually wasn't white or gold, but I think it was navy blue, but it was just a great look on a man and one that we haven't seen for a long time. And I thought it would be a great thing for the Kens to wear at the party. And it also seemed to make sense that the Kens would all wear the same thing, because nobody really cares about the Kens, and so no one bothers to make them separate costumes. They just all wear the same thing. But the Barbies, on the other hand, get a great range of things to wear. And so it was really fun to do that, to delve into the Mattel archive and find different iterations of gold and white evening wear that we could rework for the Barbies. But the Kens just get the one piece. I think that one of the pleasures of doing this job is working with actors that really understand their role and the story that their character is telling. And I think on this movie, it's just been such a pleasure to work with Ryan and Margot, because both of them are really invested in their characters and telling the story. And we were constantly like talking about how we can change things to improve things, to up the ante, really, and keep pushing forward on the funniest and the best interpretations of Barbie and Ken. We come back at the end to the Barbies having regained control of their world. And I think at that point in the movie, what was appropriate for the Barbies was that each of the actors, actresses, would choose something to wear that would be expressive of their character. That maybe their character as an actor, how they wanted to interpret Barbie. I mean, in a way, what we're talking about is how you would want to represent yourself as a woman. And so each person needed to have an input in what that would be. So for Anna, it was about referencing her heritage. And we worked out, it was quite, you know, we had to do some research into how to construct a Filipino sleeve But we made a dress that she was really pleased with and that she felt would make her mother cry. And for other Barbies, they all chose different things that they felt represented either the woman that they thought their Barbie would be or something about themselves.